And the next startup that we want to introduce came to Indore to study from a very, very, very poor background. And he happened to be an engineering student and not someone who was liked very much by all his faculty. Okay? So you know what that means. This boy, when he was in the second year, he started a venture called Eggies. His plan was to sell different varieties of eggs. That didn't work. In the other year, he started something called Oogle, which was a mobile version of Google. That also didn't work. The fourth year, he didn't clear his college because he was busy doing TEDx on campus and startups. He finally managed to clear his college in the fifth year. But meanwhile, what he did was, he attempted two more startups before he worked with Jabong as a product manager. And now he runs one of the most successful startups in the country called Vidooly. He's been 3 years into operations, employs 72 employees, has touched a revenue of 6 crores, 7 crores right now. Subrat, please correct me if I'm wrong. May I welcome Subrat Kar from Vidooly, the founder of Vidooly, on stage, please.
Hello, everyone. Good evening. I can hear you, all of you. Cool. Still, my mom thinks I should have joined Infosys or TCS. Because this is not my story, it's story of every, you know, middle class Indian who come from a very, you know, different background and stand up, you know, with himself, with some doing something different. Correct. My name is Subrat. As Madalina ma'am introduced, you know, Indore, though my hometown is Jajpur, I come from a very middle class family from Jajpur, from a small town, small village. But I feel very special to Indore. I consider Indore as my second hometown. Because this is the city that taught me, you know, to be an entrepreneur, that taught me to stand out, you know, among, you know, all. And what I am today, you know, this is because of this city. And not only Indore, you know, I think, is Atul sir here? So three people are very, very, you know, closer to my heart. One is, of course, Atul sir, the NEN family, and of course, Malina ma'am. Without three people, I would not have, you know, achieved, you know, what I am today. Well, it's been 3.5 years. I started this company in 2014, November. That I remember, you know, we had zero capital. I think that was the right time and the right, you know, moment the idea clicked up, you know. And we got our first seed round of funding from Times Internet. And then we started building the product, and that's how the story started. And within the demo day itself, we got a call from Silicon Valley-based investor called BVP, Best Owner Venture Partner. And we raised another seed round of 250K. Then, you know, that's how the, you know, the story starts. You know, when you have capital, then you go to the next round of scale. You achieve those number. Yeah. So it's been a great journey, you know, being a student startup to now running a team size of 75 people, you know, we have offices across Noida and Mumbai. It's been a great journey, and there are a lot of lessons I learned, you know, throughout this journey. I'd love to, without taking much time, I'd love to quickly, you know, share those lessons so that you guys can, you know, take a context and, you know, can implement in your life. Lesson number one. Scale very fast. And I was just listening to Ramesh sir, you know, he pointed out, you know, if you don't scale, right, you can't get success. Because in today's competition, a lot of startups are coming, you know, a lot of funding are happening, you know, people are, you know, going crazily, right? If you don't scale quickly, right, you will fail. So scale doesn't mean, you know, just to, you know, start another shop in another city, right? You have to automate the entire thing, right? Be it marketing, be it, you know, HR, be it ops, be it, you know, product development, everything has to be automated, right? Think about you are, you know, traveling to Goa and you are you're running a company, you know, and you're making money, right? That is about scale. If I'm here giving a speech and if my company is making money, that is called scale, right? Point number two, right team in place, right? So team is very important, right? If you don't get the right team and right co-founder, right, you can't reach to your goal. So it's very important, you know, to have those like-minded people, you know. And of course, you know, when you share your idea to someone, you know, at the very first day, that person may not relate, may not sold to your idea. It takes time, but it's very important to have right attitude to people in a team. Point number three, traction. And traction is very important. If you are running a company or if you are starting any idea, you know, venturing into something, you should get quick traction. Why it is important? If you don't have traction, you can't raise money. People are not going to fund you on your idea, right? People need POs. People need to see anything which is a working model, right? Because this is the money, this is their hard-earned money they're going to put in your idea, right? If you don't have anything to show, these people are not going to put their hard-earned money in your venture, right? Traction is very, very important. It will help you to get your next round of funding. It will get you the cash flow. When you get cash flow, you can do a lot of experiment. You can scale your venture, which is why, you know, traction is very, very important. And to get traction, you have to figure out a way how to get the first paying customer, how to scale the product quickly, how to iterate and how to fail very first, so that with those learning, you can, you know, you can implement those feedback in your existing product. So this is very important. Point number four, as Ramesh sir, of course, you know, he has pointed out, customer delight is very, very important factor in your business, right? Whether you are running a shop, whether you are running a restaurant, whether you are running a B2B company, whether you are running a B2C company, if your product is not adding any value to a customer, if your product is not bringing back to a customer, then they go back and start again. If you're not building a high return business model, that is not bringing back to your customers at least twice or thrice in a year, then there is something wrong in your model. Because assuming if you are even playing in a very small size market and if your retention rate is not more than 30-40%, then you are not going to make, you know, high, you know, scalable, you know, venture. And last not least, money is also very important in your life. And as you all know, you know, raising capital is very, very difficult task, right? Because I have gone through these stages, you know, approaching to VCs, to angels, to all these group, you know, getting rejected by many times, and again went, again raised. So you have to understand, you know, you need money, right? Not for your lifestyle, but to scale your venture. And to raise those money, you have to be very, very, very smart, right? I have seen people who have raised their, you know, multiple rounds of funding just through a single Excel sheet and PowerPoint. I have seen people who have been struggling since last 10 years haven't raised their first round of funding. You have to be very, very smart, you know, work on the numbers, work on the matrices, understand whom you are approaching, right? What the guy want, right? What number he's looking for? By the way, I'm not that very lucky. Your Sasang, if Sasang is here, right, the founder of Fracto, Malinama told he'll be joining. These guys have, you know, I have a great respect to Sasang. These guys know how to get the money, you know, from BC pocket, right? I'm a small guy, right? We hardly raised more than a 2.5 million in the last 3 years. So money is our DNA, right? Our funder was very simple, right? We'll not raise more, we'll make more. And with God's grace and, you know, all the blessing, we are doing good. And this year we're going to close 2 million of revenue, you know, by this FY18. And of course, there are a lot of dreams, a lot of plans are in place. Hope we all together achieve. And I would like to mention one thing here, you know. I think without NEN, or without Atul sir, or without Manila ma'am, I would not have been, you know, who I am today, right? So I'll give you a very special mention to these three people, Atul sir, the entire Indian family, and Manila ma'am. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for having me. Thank you guys. All the best.